In this lecture, we'll go through the properties of regular languages and how we can form a regular language or regular expression from the given DFA. So here are some theorems. You must remember these things. That is, the class of regular languages is closed under union. That means whenever you make the union of multiple regular languages, then the result will be again in fall under the same set. So closure of a language proof: assume that A1 and A2 are regular languages, so that A1 union A2 is regular. That means if assume that an FA N1 recognize A1 and N2 recognize A2. If you combine these two machines, then final expression will also recognized by that is A1 and A1 union A2 will be recognized by the combined NFA. So that is the reason. This is a simple proof related to this. And also, and at the same time, we have also seen in the previous lectures also, when we are going for conversion of the epsilon NFA to NFA or epsilon NFA to DFA, when we go for the closure. Epsilon closure of dou e of that is dou epsilon of the things, then what we have done is we have made dou e of the input union dou e of state comma input union, like that we have made. That means all put together, if you look at it, the resultant will be again falling into the same set. So that is the reason we can say that the class of regular languages is closed under union. And here is the further explanation has been given. This is, for example, this is the first NFA that will accept the A1 as the language, and this is second NFA that will accept the A2 as the language. If you combine these two, you can also combine these two with simple epsilon, so that it will reach the final state, and these final states can also be combined with the epsilon. So this is what actually the property of the NFA and DFA, because the recognizing capacity of NFA and DFA are one and the same. That is, the language accepted by DFA and the language accepted by NFA are equal. So that reason, we are going to take a flexible machine like NFA, and we are going to prove it. So if we want to mention it formally, obviously the languages, that is, machines can be defined as a 5-tuple. We all know that. That is, the set of states, the input alphabets, transition, and the starting state and final state. So if you take two NFAs and construct this one, so for that, first of all, we need to combine the set of states, and the Q0 is the starting state, which is a new starting state, as we have seen here previously. This is a new starting state we have added here, and the final states must be combined. F is equal to F1 union F2, so that the transition table may be, written like this. Second property of regular languages is the language of regular languages is closed under concatenation. So previously we have seen regular languages are closed under union. Now here we are going to see the regular languages are also closed under the concatenation. That means if you combine these two A1 dot A2, then still it is the resultant will be fall under the same regular language set. So we all know that A1 dot A2 means we need to combine it in series. While coming to the union means plus, if plus kind of thing was appeared, then we need to place it in the parallel. So this we have seen during the coffee tea vending machine example for construction of DFA. Whenever the union is there, then you go for the parallel circuits. Whenever the dot is there, that is concatenation kind of thing is there, then we go for the series circuit. So here this is a series. So N1, the N1 will be combined with N2 with some epsilon moments. So thereby the thereby you will get the combined machine. So whenever we are combining, we should not this particular final states which are there in the first machine will not be the final states, but provided the final states in the final that is second machine will become the final states. So this is how we combined the two regular languages. If you combine regular languages, that is via concatenation, the resultant again will fall under the same regular language set. So that is the reason the N1, the first NFA and second NFA, if you put in series, the recognized language will be this particular A1.A2 will be accepted by this combined machine. So hence it is proved that the regular languages are closed under the concatenation. And here is the formal proof with the help of the tuples and how we are going to combine with some transition functions. And here the class of regular languages is closed under star. So star is nothing but a clean star, which is zero or more occurrences. You use the same idea, same thing. That is, if you have A star means epsilon dot A plus. Okay. So epsilon dot A plus means first epsilon will be there. That means without any input also this machine has to accept. So that is, this is the starting state. And plus there is A star, epsilon dot A plus means after that any number of A's can appear. That means any number of alphabets can appear. So that is the reason we are going to combine this epsilon with the rest of the machine. So this is what the third theorem related to the regular languages properties. That is, the class of regular languages is closed under the star. A is equal to A B. Whenever you say A star, then epsilon will come into the picture. Then A will come. Then A A. Next B B B B B. Like that, it will grow like anything. Next one is expression is defined as follows. A is a regular expression where A belongs to the sigma. Sigma is the alphabet set. So that the R1 union R2 is also a closure. R1 dot R2 is closure. Okay. Closure in the sense the resultant expression will again becomes the regular expression. That is what means closure means. And R star is also a closure. Epsilon is a regular expression. Then null set is also a regular expression. And if you enclose this regular expression within the brackets, still it will become a regular expression. Next one is star binds tight means here the depending upon the bracket opening and closing, the recognition will change. For example, if you look at A B star is there. This is different. This is this can also be replaced as A dot within the brackets B star. But if you combined A B whole star, then this is not equal to this previous expression. So this is you must remember the placing of brackets will also play a major role in recognizing the languages. So it is just like the writing of expressions. So in writing expressions, if you replace, if you might have placed the opening and closing brackets in a different way, obviously the resultant value will become different. So the same thing applies here. Whenever A B star is there, you should not write this as A B whole star. Okay, this star is only for this B. So B may appear or may not appear. It may appear in multiple times. So concatenation binds together than union. So A dot B union C. That means you have to write like this. There is A dot B within the brackets union C. So you should not write like this. A dot of B union C. So these are the, we can say these are the priorities that you are supposed to make use of when reading an expression. So AB or C is can be written like this, AB or C. Okay, it should not be written like A B or C. Next is A star means A, okay, or within the brackets, flower brackets, A star. a plus means a a star you can write. Okay, next one is within the brackets means it is a closed one, which can be written like this r epsilon, or we can also say that a union epsilon. So it is optional. So whenever any expression has been given like this, within the square brackets, if any alphabet has been given, then you have to assume that this is like a r epsilon. That is a union epsilon. This is what the meaning of this. That means that that particular alphabet may appear or may not appear. Next one is parsing practice. Parsing is the way of reading the given expression and checking whether the expression is according to the given grammar or not. That is what is called parsing means. For example, if you might have written an if statement in C programming, that if statement in general will be parsed by the compiler. The compiler, what it will do is it will read the if statement, then it will check whether the given written if statement is according to the given grammar, that is the fitted grammar in the C compiler or not. The same thing which is called as parsing. Now here AAB union C, AAB union C, AA is there. So this should be parsed like this AAB, because concatenation will be having more priority than the union. So it can be combined like this AAB union C, AAB union CAA. And it can also be written in such a way, instead of union, we can also mention it as a R symbol. AAB R like this. Okay. This can also be written like this finally. So this is the way we are supposed to parse the regular expression. Whenever regular expression has been given without this brackets, etc. So then in the same way, D union AB star C D star. So this this can be written like this. D as it is, we can place in the brackets. Okay, R union can also be replaced with R. Simply AB star and CD star. So here A is there. We have seen this one in the previous slide. That is AB star, okay, CD star. So this is the final result, our final expression that we can combine. So this is the way we are supposed to parse the regular expressions. And some other examples of regular expressions, it can be written like this. Assume that the alphabet set is A, B, C, D. Whenever the problem has been given, first they will give you the 5 tuples, such as the input, what is the alphabet set, what is the starting state, what is the final state. This kind of thing may be given, or directly DFA may be given. So from the DFA, we have to understand what are the possible inputs, like the alphabet set. And the rest of things will go normally, like we discussed in the previous things. So that means there are two ways of asking the question. That is one by giving the 5 tuples. That is the set of states, number of alphabet set, the starting state, ending state, and transition function. Or simply a DFA may be given. So that by DFA you have to extract the 5 states and you can go further. So A is the expression. Simply you can write in within A B C C D. So this can also be combined within one thing. A B union C D. If this kind of thing was given, this can be written like this A B R C D. If you want to represent as a set, it has to be represented like this A B comma C D. While coming to this A within the brackets B union C D, that means you may get A B D or A C D. This is R symbol. So this is what the resultant expression. So A B star C. That means B may appear or may not appear. If it appears any number of times, it may appear. So without appearing of B, A C. If B has appeared for one time, then ABC. If B appeared for two times, then ABBC, like that. This is the way you are supposed to expand the string. See, please remember the expression or the language string. These are the words will be used interchangeably. We can say this ABBC. Okay, for example, this ABBC is there. This I can call it as a string. String is nothing but which is a group of characters, which are group of characters. Here, what are the characters? These are the characters. Or we can also say these characters are belong to the alphabet set. That is what the meaning of string here. So in some textbooks you will find it as a string. In some textbooks you will find it as a language. Okay, like that you will find. But this finest unit is there. This is called as a string. So A B union epsilon C. That means B union epsilon means B or star. That means B star you will get. So it can be combined like this: A within the square brackets B C. So it can be written like A B C or B also you can write. Like that empty set and other things are there. If empty set star means epsilon will come into the picture. Whenever the star is there, epsilon will come. Otherwise, empty set is always a empty set. Nothing will be there in this. So this is the way anything with the anything union with the empty set will become the empty set only. This is what the another expression of the regular expression. And some of the regular expressions, each regular expression describes a language. So which language it describes, it will represent the regular language. So L of A is equal to A, L of R1 or R2 is equal to L of R1 union L of R2. Like that, whatever the expressions we have seen, the same thing with respect to the language. So these regular expressions will result into the language that is called regular language. And whatever the properties applied for these regular expressions will same will apply for the languages also. Regular languages are closed under the union, concatenation and star. This one must remember. Regular expressions describe regular languages. And regular languages are identified by or recognized by the finite automata. Either it may be NFA or DFA. The language is regular if and only if some regular expression describes it. Otherwise, it is not a regular language. That means there must be some regular expression which will define this language. So a language is regular if and only if it is recognized by some finite automata, that is finite machine, either it may be NFA or DFA. Given a regular expression E, the language it describes is L of E is the L of E. So we are saying that the class of languages recognized by the DFAs or NFAs and regular expression is the same. Because we have discussed previously, the NFA and DFA are having the same equivalent power. And these are the lemmas that one must remember. If a regular language is, or if a language is described by a regular expression, then it is regular. Proof is use the closure of union, star and concatenation. So obviously all these are in the closure form. So obviously they will become the regular, which is the property of regular expression, and again it will follow as the regular expression. So second one is from a regular expression build a NFA to recognize it. So thereby if you can form a NFA from the given regular expression, then obviously if the NFA accepts the regular expression, obviously it will become a regular one. And lemma two is if a language is regular, then it can be described by a regular expression. So it's the same thing what we have discussed so far orally, as I theoretically they are going to present here. So for this, what you are supposed to do is you go for the forming of DFA and try to recognize this DFA, try to make the expression to be recognized by DFA. Another lemma, we have a regular expression, call it as R, convert R to NFA and conclude that the language must be regular. So it's a very simple one. Whenever R is there, obviously you will be going for the parallel circuits, two parallel circuits, again combine them and to get the final recognizable version of the machine. And here the definition of regular expression, R is equal to A, R is equal to R2, R is equal to R1, R2, like that so many expressions are there. So R is equal to A, that is simply if you have mentioned like this, then the starting state and ending state will be there. So this entire, again, we are going to repeat the same thing here, but okay, which is again repeating and repeating again. The same concepts we are going to see in multiple ways. Okay, the same thing we discussed during the coffee tea vending machine, how to go for the forming of the machine. And let we'll go through the lemmas first, so that it will be easy for us to understand the properties. If a language is regular, then it can be described by a regular expression. So it is a vice versa. That is, if a regular expression is there, we can generate the language. If the language is there, then obviously by observing the pattern of the language, we can find the regular expression. And here is the NFA, and this is the NFA with the epsilon moments, and this is the NFA only one edge between the states. So NFA, and we are also having some fully connected NFA. So like that, for any NFA we can have epsilon NFA, and for if you have epsilon NFA you can have DFA. So like that you can have the combinations. So convert from the DFA to GNFA, generalized NFA. Generalized NFA will be consisting of this epsilon moments. So these are the things like add a start state for this empty which is a start state, which is the epsilon moment. Then finally add a new acceptance state. Instead of final state, you'll go for a new final acceptance state, where you add that final state with the epsilons. Eliminate the multiple edges with union, like A or B or C. So thereby add all the missing edges. So finally you will get this particular epsilon, that is generalized NFA. So it is very easy. Whenever this generalized NFA is there, getting back to the DFA is difficult. But with the DFA, you can draw the generalized NFA like this. Simply, you can move on to any state with some epsilon moments. So if you look at this example, so here is the DFA. Here the alphabets are like this: 0, 1, 2. These are the alphabets. And here B is the starting state. Then C is the final state. If you want to convert it as a generalized R epsilon based NFA, then add a new state before this, like A. And from the new state, which you make it as the new state as the starting state. And from starting state with epsilon moment, directly you come to P. From the starting state with epsilon moment, you can directly go to the C also. And for any given DFA, first you need to add a new starting state and a new ending state. Make the ending state as the normal state. Okay. And whenever 0, 1 is there, you make it as 0 or 1. And for from every state to other state, represent an epsilon moment. So this is the way you are supposed to convert into the epsilon NFA. Whenever the R kind of thing is there, just to make combine all the R things and make it as star. Like 0 or 1 is there, so it is a series of it is a sequence of inputs, like a 0 or 1 or 2, like that it is there. Then make it a combined 0 or 1 or 2 like that, and whole star you make it, so that you will get an epsilon moment there. So this is the way of converting the DFA to the generalized NFA. Now we'll see the regular languages and finite state machines. Anyhow, we have seen that the regular languages are accepted by the finite state machine. So given a regular expression, with regular expression we'll get the regular languages, and with regular languages we'll get the finite state machine. In this finite state machine we have two categories, NFA and DFA. So this is the way we will be having this particular summary. This we have been discussing from several times, the same thing. And if you might have developed a generic platform or generic expression to have this particular, or we can say to generate an expression, then it has to be regular grammar. So the regular grammar can be either right linear or left linear, but it cannot be recursive in nature. Okay. So with the regular grammar, we can form the regular expressions. From the regular expressions, whatever the resultant outputs are there, those we can call it as regular languages. And these regular languages are acceptable finite state machines. And these finite state machines may be either NFA or DFA or epsilon NFA. So there is a possibility of conversion from an DFA to the generalized NFA, or NFA to DFA, epsilon NFA to NFA, and NFA to DFA, or directly from epsilon NFA to DFA. These are the things we have seen in our lectures so far. So here all the strings containing exactly four zeros. Four zeros means first you make the four states which accept the four zeros. Okay. After that four zeros, if any other input comes, then it should be non-terminating state. That is what the thing called here. The all strings that contain exactly four zeros. So first four zeros, thereby you accept it. With first you may get one or zero. Okay. After zero, you may get several ones, but a given expression should have at least of four zeros. So thereby it will reach the final state. After achieving four zeros, if you have of zeros or ones, it should go into the non-terminating state, so that the by the end of this string, the given DFA will not accept the string. So thereby the design will become correct. Next one is all strings ending in 1101. So directly you create a final state with the occurrence of ending with 1101. Then you need to think of what are the possible other inputs that you may get for every state. So if you look at here, so if I have given only 1101, it has to accept it because it don't have any prefix or suffix. So that is the reason 1101 directly it will accept the given string. Now whenever instead of one may get zeros also in the beginning. Okay, if you get one, then it will go here. After providing one, if you have zero, if you have one, for example, if the input is 1 4 zeros, then 1 0, okay, again here 0 0 0, but it won't, by the end of the string 1 0 0 0, it is not ending in the final state, so this string will not be accepted. Only the string which is ending with 1101 will be accepted with this DFA. So that is the reason first you need to draw the DFA for direct acceptance of 1101. Then you need to think of what are the possible prefix, that is the string that may come before this, or the string that may come after this. So if the input is given like this, 1101 with three zeros. So 1101 up to here is okay, but if you got three zeros, then zero, again on the state 0 0 0. So by the end of the string, it is not in the final state, so the given string will be rejected. So this is the way you are supposed to form the thing. Next one is all containing exactly four zeros and at least two ones. So this is a somewhat complex design. Four zeros, it should have consisting of exactly four zeros and at least two ones. So at least means minimum two ones must be there, can have any number of strings, any number of ones. But the first case is exactly four strings, exactly four zeros. Exactly four zeros means if five zeros comes and minimum two ones are there, still it should not accept. So that is the reason it is a little bit complex design. So here is a design, all strings containing exactly four zeros and at least two ones. So four zeros, okay, exactly 4 zeros, 0, 0, 0, 0, 4 zeros, okay, and at least 2 ones, 1, 1, okay, this is the best way, first in the initial state, we'll draw this, and finally, it will get the final, it will come into the final state. So, a minimum 2 ones, after that, you can have any number of ones, so obviously, can have any number of ones. If you get another 0 after this, then automatically it should end in the non-terminating state. So instead of in the beginning, instead of 0, you may get 1 also. After providing input, you may have the other string with 1. So like that, you can have any combinations. So we need to design the machine for accepting those combinations. So that is the reason here, division has been made here. One, if the input is 0 on the starting state, then it will go in this direction. If the input is 1 on the starting state, since in the problem statement we have at least 2 ones are there, so first we'll go for the at least 2 ones drawing, then you can have any number of ones, but along with this one we have 4 zeros to be accepted. So 0 0 0 0, this will be accepted now. So this is the way we need to design all possible inputs for all possible inputs at every state, and finally the design must reach to the design must reach the satisfying of the problem statement, that is exactly 4 zeros and at least 2 ones. Next thing is all strings whose binary are in binary interpretation are is divisible by 5. That means the DFA must accept all strings that are divisible by 5. So what are the all strings that are divisible by 5? 0 can be divisible by 5. 5 can be divisible. 10 can be divisible. 15 can be divisible. 20, 25. These are the things can be divisible. So all these numbers you convert into binary number. So whenever 0 is converted into binary of 4 bits, then 0, 0, 0, 0. While coming to this 5, 0, 1, 0, 1. If it is coming to 10, 1, 0, 1, 0. If it is coming to 15, all 1s. So you need to understand what are the common common symbols in that, and take the common symbols out, and you need to go for the drawing of the DFA. So first, if the input itself is 0, any number of zeros, obviously it will become 0, so it has to accept it. If 0, 1, 0, 1, which is 5, it has to accept it. Okay, next one is 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, has to accept it. So after 1010, any number of zeros to be accepted, because either the 5 division means 5 or 0 will be divided by 5. So the reason, if it is 0, then at the end you can have any number of zeros. So 1010 can be accepted. So previously in our lecture, we have seen the construction of DFA that accepts the numbers divisible by 3. So it is in 3 we have seen 2x plus 1 and 2x kind of thing. But in case of 5, we have to see x, 5x, other things. So that means we need to draw a DFA that should reject the remainders as 1, 2, 3 and 4. So it should be in a position to accept the remainders as 0. Okay. So that is the way we will form this particular DFA. Next one is all strings that contains the substring 0101. Substring means this string can appear at the beginning or at the ending or at the middle. So first of all, you assume that only this 0101 has appeared. Then if only 0101 appeared, obviously the DFA has to accept it. There is no other go. So directly draw the DFA for accepting 0101. Then you need to think of if any string appears as a prefix to this, okay, so for that you need to design the input and a probable output state for the states at the beginning. So that is, as part of this, if you look at here 0101, it will accept. But if it starts with 1110101, then obviously it will be this one. Next one is if it starts with 0 and afterwards any number of zeros followed by 0101, then it has to accept it. If it is 0 1, afterwards there are multiple zeros and 1, then 0 1, afterwards multiple ones, okay, and 0101 is there, then still it should be in a position to accept it. After 0101, if you have any number of strings, okay, any possible number of combinations of zeros and ones, still it should be in a position to accept. So this is a very very logical way of thinking required for this. The reason is, whenever a string has been given like this, if it is a substring kind of thing, the substring can be prefix, the substring can be middle, the substring can be at the end. So by keeping it in mind, you are supposed to design this particular DFA. Next, all strings that start with 0 and has odd length, or start with 1 and has even length. So all strings that start with 0 and has odd length. Odd length means the length of the string is odd number. And it starts with 1 and have the even length. For example, a string is like this, 1 followed by 3 zeros. 1 followed by 3 zeros means it is starting with 1 and total length of the string is 4. Like that. So if such cases, it has to accept it. So all strings that start with 0 and have odd lengths. So if 0 is there, the length of the string is 1 only, so it has to accept it. And it is starting with 0, and if you have the string like this 001, then for 0, again 0 it is going here and 1 here. So 001, the length of the string is odd number, so still it is accepting this. If the given string is 1 followed by 4 zeros, 1 followed by 4 zeros, 0, 0, 0. So finally it is accepting it. So 1 followed by 4 zeros, the length of the string is even in nature. So that is the reason this DFA is accepting the given problem statement. Next one is all strings that do not contain substring as 110. All strings that do not contain substring as 110 means, I told you in the beginning that try to draw a DFA that accepts the 110. Okay, try to draw a DFA that accepts the 110 and 110 as the substring, and make the final states as the non-final states and non-final states as the final states in the constructed DFA. Then it will become the don't. Don't means negation of the DFA. Whenever you say negation of DFA, terminal states will become the non-terminal states. Non-terminal states will become the terminal states. So here is the example that if the substring is 110 to be accepted, if you convert this non-terminal state to the terminal state, obviously 110, this will become the terminal state. Now after construction, we can convert this terminating state to the non-terminating state and remaining other states as the terminating states. So thereby all strings that do not contain the string 110 will be accepted by this DFA. Next is all strings of length at most 5. So minimum 5 length string must be accepted. If it is other than 5, obviously it should not accept the given input. All strings where every odd position is 1. Every odd position means 1, 0, 1, 0 is there. Okay, first position is 1, second position is 0, and third position is 1, fourth position is 0, like that. So every odd position is 1. So if it is only 1, then we can accept this string. 1, 0, again 1. Okay, 1, 0, again 1. So it will be accepted. Okay, and 1, 1, 1 is there. Still, it should be positioned to accept. 1, okay, 1, again 1. So this is all strings where every odd position is 1. So these are the problems related to the DFA. While coming to the NFAs, NFAs are very easy to draw, you are aware of. In the next lecture, we will complete this DFA with output.